Garage Comedian.
It's a beautiful day for a joke.
And now it's time for Garage Comedian News.
I mean, that's real news.
Hello and welcome back to the Garage Comedian News. I'm the Garage Comedian. As if 2020 couldn't get any worse, the pandemic has now brought upon a coin shortage due to the lack of cash flow. And in future news, America has a surplus of gumballs and bouncy balls. But instead of complaining about the coin shortage, why doesn't someone do something about it? If I was in charge, I would commission the Goonies to jump into wishing wells and fish out some copper and nickel.
I'm taking it back. I'm taking them all back.
It's called a workable solution, and quite frankly, there's just too few of them coming out of Washington these days. Sticking with Goonies for 400, Alex, I actually met actor Robert Davi back in 2006.
I'm beginning to like this kid much.
I was working for a private jet company back then and flew out to Burbank, California to meet up with Sylvester Stallone, James Caan, and the aforementioned Robert Davi. Oh, hold on a second. Let me just pick up all those names I dropped and put them back in my pocket. I also met up with Ryan Seacrest. That was fun. He was emceeing a charity wine auction for Napa Valley, and they had chartered a private jet to take him over from Burbank. I have two Seacrest stories for you. One I witnessed firsthand, along with my colleagues April and Stephanie, and the other I heard from the flight attendant who took him over and then came back. Oh, that was my mom. She said if I don't have something nice to say, that I shouldn't say it at all. So I guess that's the end of that story. But between you and me, if you thought that Seacrest was a giant
douchebag,
we'll go to the next story now. Oh, this next story is an appropriate segue. There's a tampon tax lawsuit being filed against the state of Michigan, aiming to repeal a tax on menstrual hygiene products, alleging that such a tax is sex-based discrimination. Now, I am ill-equipped to offer any additional commentary on this matter. In fact, this topic makes me both nervous and sweaty. So, that's the end of this story, period. And now here's Barrett with a look at the weather.
Oh boy, front coming our way. Look out.
No one looks at the weather quite like my son. Love you, buddy.
Bill Connors.
Frigid Arctic air.
Joe Biden announced that his running mate for 2020 would be Kamala Harris this past week to go up against the Trump-Pence ticket. Trump's approval ratings are way down right now in the 37 to 39% range. The last time it was that low 3 months out going into an election was Jimmy Carter and George H.W. Bush. When they were seeking re-election, of course, neither got them. It's entirely possible that a Biden-Harris card could prevail this fall. Joe Biden turned 78 in November, and with the average life expectancy for men in the U.S. 76, it's safe to say that Uncle Joey's on borrowed time. Oh, and in future news, Kamala Harris is president. And sticking with presidents for 800, Alex, it was 20 years ago this month that actor Harry Hamlin played the president in the movie Quarantine, in which he discovers that a deadly virus is spreading.
So you're saying it can be spread by coughing or sneezing, like a case of the flu?
Yes, the same. And if the village is the model we use, no one survives.
Well, at least that's just a movie. It was also 20 years ago this month that the cult classic Bring It On was released. I'm on it. I'm hot. I'm everything you're not.
I have no professional training of singing
no.
or dancing, so.
Well, there's the surprise of the century.
That's the news. Good night, and have a pleasant tomorrow. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more funny videos like this, click the subscribe button. The more you know. Bow, bow, bow.